Hello, this is Heather Hoffman, and today I have a bright, fun, wintry tree scene to share with you using some distress inks paired up with the November 2019 Kit of the Month. I loved all those tree images, and I don't know, I didn't realize until I got my kit and opened it that each of those trees was individual. I thought it was all one big border stamp, so I thought it was kind of fun that you can rearrange them and do them however you want. I ended up lining mine up just like the picture on the packaging for the Kit of the Month. Or at least pretty close. I kind of went with the tall trees on the side. And I went ahead and lined these up. I'm using watercolor paper from Tim Holtz. I'm using the smoother side of the watercolor paper. And I'm masking off the bottom. It ended up masking with my post-it tape a little more than I really wanted. So I ended up just kind of folding it around to the back so that it would just mask a little line. Just because I wanted to make sure the line of those trees was perfect at the bottom. And it was harder to make them all match up without just doing that. So I just wanted it to mask off a tiny bit. Now I'm using Distress Ink Cubes to ink these up. And the colors I'm using are Ripe Persimmon, Peeled Paint, Fossilized Amber, Peacock Feathers, and Candied Apple. I'm just inking up the stamp with each cube. I misted it with water, and then I stamped. And look at that fun image. Distress inks, water, and red rubber are just such a perfect combination. I always love just how beautifully they stamp. And I had kind of a different plan when I started, but I ended up liking that stamped image so much that I was going to stamp black over the top and kind of let the ink colors bleed out around. But as soon as I stamped that, I just kind of fell in love with that image. So I decided to leave it as is and just add some coordinating paint splatters with those exact same colors of Distress Ink. So all I'm doing is kind of smooshing them onto a clear stamp block, adding a little bit of water with a small brush, and just adding little tiny splatters. And it's kind of hard to see in the video because I'm using a really fine brush because I wanted little tiny fine splatters. The larger the brush, the larger the splatters you'll get. You can see that green maybe a little bit better, probably just because it's darker and has a little more contrast. In hindsight too, I wish I thought to leave the mat. I probably would have left that mask along the bottom until I finished the splatters, but I didn't think about that until I was halfway done adding them. So I still like the effect and the way it worked out, but I think it would have been kind of neat to have that masked off line at the bottom without any splatters. So I added some with each of those colors, and again, they're super tiny and fine splatters there. I don't know if you can see them a little better there. And the little spots where they hit the trees too, they kind of react and mix together a little. So it was kind of a simple and fun little effect with that. I like how these are, I always see these trees and think winter and snow and Christmas, so it's kind of fun to do them in bright colors, and instead of snow, do bright colored splatters on the background as well. Now I'm going to go ahead and add a sentiment from the Kit of the Month. You might notice I spun it around to look and make sure I had it right side up. I've done that before where I stamp it upside down on accident, and that's never fun, so I double check that to make sure I had it right. And just stamp that in black over the top using my Misti. And then I'm just gonna trim a little border all the way around the edges. I'm basically taking a quarter inch off of each edge. I could have trimmed it down first, because I ended up having everything centered the way I wanted. But by trimming it afterwards, if anything had been crooked or uneven, that would have given me an opportunity to kind of fix that a little bit at that moment, which is kind of helpful sometimes. I'm going to adhere this on a panel of some deep gray cardstock, just enough to add a little bit of a border around the edges. So I always use a larger piece than I need generally, and then adhere it up in one corner and then just trim those extras off. That seems to me the easiest way to do that. Now with that little border on there to help that pop, I can adhere that onto my white card base and have a finished card there. That's all you need. It's amazing how quick and simple this is, and it would be fun to do in a whole different rainbow of colors. Add the splatters in different colors, do all the trees in different colors. I'd love to play with different possibilities, put together a set or something of this. Anyway, thanks so much for coming by. I hope you enjoyed. Have a wonderful day.